Hey, thanks for checking us out. I'm Court Crossan. This is Crossan C's Business Ideas. And this week I'm going to be covering a social media management agency. Now, if you're always online, always on social media, you might as well make a business out of it. And that being said, remember to like, share, subscribe. Also in the description box below, there's going to be a link to my number one way to make money online. Click on it, get on my email list, and watch the video afterwards. It's a video that really helped me get when I was getting started online and started my own business, and it got me connected to a community of people that helped me out and supported me and just fed me good vibes too. That being said, let's get to that video. All right, social media agency, that's our business idea today. Now, if you're already doing social media, then that's great because you're immersed in it. You know the trends. It's something that you know intuitively. If you look at people like Sam Walton or even Bill Gates and stuff, they're immersed in what they're getting into. And that's very important to be successful in anything, pretty much, and especially in business. I'm not saying if you are not immersed in it right now, you'll fail at it, but you just have a little bit more to learn than someone who's in it every day and notices trends off the bat, notices what good content is, and even a lot of the tricks on how to gain followers you probably already know. And those are skill sets that you could actually make money off of. So what does a social media management agency do? Create social media content for other companies and post it on their behalf. Organize and execute content campaigns and maintain a company's image. So that's really important. A lot of it has to do with planning. A lot of it has to do with how the company wants to be perceived. Like a beard company is not going to be perceived as, let's say, like the same as Bath and Body Works. You know, they don't have the same image. Even with like workouts and yoga has a totally different image than powerlifting, and CrossFit has a totally different image as from Olympic lifters and stuff like that. So depending on your client, your company, and their target audience, is it's important that when you put out the content that you maintain their image. Let's go to the next slide. All right, what kind of services can you provide? Now, this is really important. This is just some ideas with it, your services that you provide for something, but it could be as simple as just scheduling content. Like, you don't have to start off huge by running huge social media campaigns, setting up paid ads, running banners, all those things. What you could really just start off as managing their accounts and simply scheduling content, making sure everything's right, writing out descriptions for their photos and stuff like that, or even creating content. So some of the services that you can provide is content creation and scheduling. That's easy, especially if there's something like the car detailing. It's easy to do, right? Or have them take pictures of their work and then send them to you, and you post it and stuff like that. Run deals and promotions. So you come up with ways to sell their product online organically. You could even use a tool as simple as Canva to edit the photos, to put banners on it, to maybe you even get into contact with influencers in the same niche or something related that the target audience is following. And reputation management. This is more advanced, but this has to go in with reviews like on Yelp or something like that, or even on their fan page, answering their stuff, making sure that their negative reviews are being managed and that their positive reviews are being highlighted. And then social commerce. Now, that is monetizing their social media accounts. Basically, what you're doing is like connecting their account with a landing page and collecting leads, or sending them to their website, or making sure that they're actually capitalizing on the earning potential that they can have from their social media accounts and the reach. It's not just something to look cool on that a lot of people have. They're actually using the social media as a way to generate income. So is there a market for it? Absolutely. Many times brick and mortar business owners feel like they just don't have the time to do it, or they just don't know how to do it. They feel out of the loop. That's where you come in. You specialize in content marketing. And think about it. They're business owners. They run a business. They know how to hire people. They do not want to spend their time. Well, most of them don't want to spend their time putting out content, like editing, making it really good, researching hashtags, researching demographics for certain social media platforms. They don't want to do all that stuff. You can do that stuff. And the thing is, a lot of it is data and a lot of it is research. So once you know things, you just organize that data and then you use it for your clients. And so once you know the personality of the platform, you know the demographic that they're going for, things start to fall in line and you just notice trends more often and more notice trends that are relevant to your client. So who would you target as a customer? And pick a field that you're comfortable with. Like if you have to learn a whole bunch of new like words, a new definition, and you have to learn a whole new lingo, I wouldn't start off with that. I mean, like, might as well go out there and level up a few times. But just starting off, you might just want to go with personal trainers, bars, restaurants, independent contractors. But you could also do realtors, dentists, lawyers, people that typically are very hands-on, real world, and when it comes to social media, they're just kind of confused. Think of the kind of person that asks their kid to help them with their computer sort of thing. They're so real world that when it comes to social media, they're just kind of baffled with it. And they're so, social media is so intricate that you really have to focus and you really have to learn it. It's a whole ecosystem. And brick and mortar businesses many times don't really have that skill set, and that's where you come in. So what do you need to start? You need a working knowledge of social media platforms. You know how to use it. Like, you need to know how to use it, which social media has what's their demographics. Instagram has like 3 or 4 different channels. They have their TV, they have their Reels, they have a Live, I believe, or is that TikTok? Well, anyway, as you can tell, I don't specialize in social media platforms, but you have to have a working knowledge of it. You need to know the personality of whichever social media platform you choose to work with. Like, LinkedIn is mostly for business to business, very professional, while TikTok is just all about fun. Instagram, a little less, but then you go to Facebook and it's starting to be an older demographic, and they're actually having a hard time attracting young people because of that. So knowing that, then you can actually help strategize for your client. Authority website. You need this if you're going to be working with other businesses. If you're dealing with like just Joe Schmo on the side, you could probably get away without having an authority site. But if you have an authority website and you're able to rank your own account, your own social media accounts, like get plenty of followers, get people doing it and actually generating leads that way, then that's awesome. Then that's a lot of authority that you can use to attract clients. But authority website is important. They need to know how to contact you. Also having your business license would be great. But if all that stuff is looking kind of hard for you, if you don't really know how to do that, or it's sounding a little intimidating, one thing you can do is that there are social media franchises out there. Like there's a franchise, a social media management agency that provide training for you. So basically you buy into their franchise and you get trained by them to run a social media platform. You know, they teach you how to provide certain services, and there you go. And one of the main things is outsource. You got to outsource some of this if you want to get bigger or just hire employees. So yeah, you don't have to do this all by yourself. There, like, entrepreneurship is not really a solo game. There's certain things like affiliate marketing, but I still outsource a lot of things. So what does it pay? Depending on the service you provide, it's I've seen as low as $100 plus a month. Also charge a setup fee. That just balances out the software and the tools that you're going to need to do, and accounts you're going to have to open. But $100 a month, I'm not talking about the full blown package for $100. I'm talking about scheduling posts and writing descriptions. Like, $100 a month would be it. And as a business owner, that is totally worth it. Let's think about it. A realtor is going to get leads from your posts for only $100 a month. That realtor, like, a lead can potentially be worth loads of money, like in the thousands, right? So hope that helped. I believe that's the whole thing. Yes, that's the whole thing. I hope that helped. Hope this idea really gets you inspired, especially if you're just starting out in business and just looking for things to do. I'm Core Crossing. This is Crossing C's Business Ideas. Now, if you want to know a way to make money online. Yeah, I mean, you don't need a product or service. You actually just promote other people's products and service. Get on my email list. I there's a bunch of courses that teach this, and I've selected the best ones that I found. And so get on the email list, check out my emails, and that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching. Like, share, subscribe, and thank you.